A dumpling. Seemingly so pure and delicate on the outside, but it's what's inside that really matters. Fruit Chan's 2004 film, Dumplings, tells the tale of a miracle dumpling that promises to restore the beauty of youth. Made by Aunt May, these dumplings possess anti-aging effects at an extreme. Mrs. Lee, an aging former actress, finds power in consuming these dumplings, in hopes of regaining her younger looks and attention of her unfaithful husband. Yet with every promise lurks a darker secret. In this case, it's hiding in the dumpling itself, chopped up remnants of an unborn child. Dumplings is a dark satire, intertwining the ethical issues of a capitalist culture with disturbing social taboos and grotesque imagery to stimulate terror in the horrors of modern society. In this video, I will further explore two of these issues, a growing class divide and increasing commoditization of beauty in contemporary consumer society. Throughout the film, which takes place in modern Hong Kong, Chan hints at the problems of class disparities, especially referencing the growing wealth gap by comparing the idealized Hong Kong middle class and Chinese immigrant working class through visually contrasting the lives of Mrs. Lee and Aunt May. In the beginning of the film, when Mrs. Lee initially pays a visit to try Aunt May's famous dumplings, she enters wearing a tight red dress and carries a red purse, which serves to drastically contrast the disheveled white blouse on Aunt May. In Chinese culture, red signifies wealth and fortune, and white on the other hand resembles purity and renewal, which seems fitting for Aunt May's 30-year-old appearance. The camera then follows Mrs. Lee through Aunt May's neighborhood as well, and with her bright dress, she inevitably stands out alone in the midst of the dusty gray background of buildings and people living in poverty. In this scene, Mrs. Lee is representative of just a minority of people living comfortably in Hong Kong. In addition, taking note of the dialogue exchange between the two women reveals the contrasting values and modes of thinking between the two classes. When Aunt May and Mrs. Lee walks to her renovating house after saving a bowl of dumplings, they begin to talk about their distinctive life choices. She argues that Mrs. Lee is trapped in an endless system of regaining her husband's attention by fighting against her inevitable aging. Aunt May, on the other hand, is her own boss and can control her own life choices. Yet, little does she know, she too is trapped in the system, a capitalist system of poverty. A later scene shows Aunt May looking up from her tower of apartment buildings, which was cinematically designed to look like the lunchbox where she initially hides her imported fetuses. With the camera angle zooming on Aunt May and the tower, it seems as if Aunt May herself becomes just like one of her fetus victims, helpless and trapped in the capitalist struggle between the working and middle classes' need to succeed. By continuing her dumpling business, Aunt May is succumbing to the capitalist system as well. More importantly, with abortion and cannibalism as dominant tropes in the film, Chan utilizes them at its extreme to underline the horrors of class disparities. In referencing the wealth gap of Hong Kong, Chan also remarks on the inaccessibility of getting an abortion in Hong Kong. In a private hospital, the cost to do so cut off accessibility to the majority of the poor population. In consequence, most women turn to the black market, seeking illegal abortions at makeshift clinics like Aunt May's. When Kate, a pregnant teen, comes to May to avoid the expenses of a legal abortion, she takes advantage of her poverty to carelessly take the fetus as profit for her dumplings. The bloody consequences that come that night stimulate fear and horror, relying on revulsion to depict Kate later violently bleeding to death. As a passenger on the bus raises his hand to reveal red ooze dripping from his fingertips, the scene suddenly flashes to Kate, laying on the street behind the bus, with a pool of blood forming from under her skirt. Perhaps the most prominent and modern social taboo crosses into plastic surgery and the constant pressure on outward appearance. According to Hong Kong Economic Journal, plastic surgery rates amongst Hong Kong teenagers have been escalating in recent years. Revenue in skincare products in Hong Kong also amounts up to $815.7 million and is expected to grow by 1.8% every year. Chan satirically depicts how far women are willing to break moral character to conform to these societal beauty standards. There are multiple shots of Aunt May in her apartment, depicting her as she touches her body sexually, admiring and caressing her glass skin and prized curves. Shot through a mirror reflecting Aunt May, it puts the viewers in her eyes. Yet, in other scenes, Chan also experiments with shot reverse shot angles to bind Mrs. Lee and Aunt May in comparison. As the shot alternates between the two women alongside the exchange of dialogue, it subconsciously invites viewers to compare their physical features, which is representative of the type of ideology present in Asian cultures. Furthermore, Chan highlights Mrs. Lee's gradual transition into a monster, as she increasingly resorts to abortions and cannibalism to achieve a youthful appearance. While she initially flinches away from defeat as dumplings, near the end of the film, she ends up desperate and addicted for more, as if she needs its anti-aging effects to survive. After visiting Aunt May multiple times for her dumplings, she finally asks her and begins discussing how to better cook the dumplings. In multiple scenes near the end, Mrs. Lee wears a white jacket with a red blouse inside, which quite almost resembles the fetus dumpling itself. While the white signifies innocence and youth, true evil resides in her, revealed by her selfish desire for beauty at the cost of a life. In the final scene, the angle of Mrs. Lee picking up a bloody fetus from below the glass bowl, along with the meat cleaver, serves as a visual reminder of how far the capitalist-driven desires for beauty can go. Yet, the true horror comes when one realizes eating this miracle dumpling no longer sounds as extreme when compared to going under the knife to physically alter one's appearance. By the end, not only does Mrs. Lee's physical appearance change in the end, but her moral values do so as well. She becomes a monster, hidden by a youthful facade. Like innocent follow-ups enveloping Aunt May's dumplings, idealized values of a capitalist society covers up its darker reality. Behind Hong Kong's image of a booming economy lies the growing wealth gap, plagued by insufficient healthcare and illegal abortions. Under the beautiful faces of young women like Aunt May lies a victim, trapped by corrupt beauty standards. But especially beneath the bouncy, glowing skin of Mrs. Lee exists not only a victim, but also a cannibalistic monster. Ultimately, Fu Chan leaves viewers questioning not only the morals behind a capitalist culture, but the morals within themselves. How much is too much?